what you need to know about managing your septic system.
Our role as the health unit is to ensure that all septic systems that are installed as per the Ontario Building Code. We also want to ensure that no water supplies or environmental issues will arise. If your home is in a city, your sewage likely goes to a sanitary sewer system, and then it goes to a sewage treatment plant. If you live in a rural area or if you own a cottage, your sewage likely goes to a private septic system. A septic system is important to protect your health, your environment, and your investment. There are many contaminants in wastewater, such as viruses, parasites, and high levels of nitrates. If these things are not treated properly, it can reach your drinking water supply and cause health concerns and environmental problems. Septic systems are the responsibility of the homeowner. It is up to you to ensure your septic system is functioning properly. Have your well water tested at least 3 times a year for indicator bacteria. Have your tank inspected and pumped every 3 to 5 years. Some pumps and water treatment devices, such as water softeners, should never be connected to your septic system. Avoid any heavy objects or vehicles on top of your tile bed. Make sure only grass is planted on top of your tile bed. Things like trees, shrubs, and gardens should never be planted on top. Some warning signs that there may be a problem with your septic system are things like the area around your tank or your pipes may be soft or spongy to walk on. If after a rainfall you smell strong odors of your septic, if E. coli is found near any well water, is if you have black or gray sewage coming back into your house or surfacing on the ground outside. If your drains are also draining a lot slower than usual, that is also another sign. Ignoring the small signs that your septic system may be failing could lead to big problems. Things like causing people to get sick from E. coli and having a big, big mess to clean up. The HKPR District Health Unit has an agreement with its local municipalities to enforce the legislation affecting private sewage systems. So once you've come to the health unit and filled out an application, a review will be made of your application. Once approved, you will receive a septic system permit. Once you have the permit, construction can start. Construction can only be done by you as the homeowner or by a licensed septic installer. Once the bed is installed, a health unit inspector will come out to do a final inspection, and then you can get your final report. So if you live in a rural area, remember, if you take good care of your septic system, you will save yourself time, money, and a potential messy situation. And remember, if you do have any questions or concerns, you can always contact your local health unit.